Hello there, this is Jesse Coffey with one of my filler videos. And these are videos that I do when I'm in between the period where I re-upload Tyler Tries to Do His Backs openings, my own openings, and my surprise videos. And this is a little curiosity. What I'm going to discuss here is a little curiosity that I have in my collection. This is one of the oldest records I own. A double record 45 RPM set of The Little Engine That Could from RCA Victor in 1949. Though the recordings on the disc are originally from 1944. And this one has music by Norman Lennon and conducted by Henry Monet. And this is from the Little Nipper series. What else do we have? We have, "When I bark, you turn the pages in the book," says Nipper, the RCA Victor pup. Although internationally, he was the EMI pup. And atop here, it says, "Narrated by Paul Wing." Paul Wing is a pretty interesting guy. He was born in 1891 in New York. And he hosted a lot of radio shows during the golden age of radio, including Paul Wing's Spelling Bee, which he hosted not only on radio but also on experimental television for W2XBS in New York. Prior to that, he was a reporter for the Chicago Tribune, and he also had a series on NBC Radio where he read children's stories, and then that transpired a recording career where he read where he did these little book and record read-alongs for RCA Victor, not only for RCA Victor but also for a children's label RCA had called Bluebird, which I think was an on and off again label of RCA's. Don't quote me on that, but I think it was. Late in his life, he became an assistant director at Paramount. He died in 1957 in Portsmouth, Virginia. And yes, he was an assistant director at Paramount Pictures. The company with the bunch of mountains that's owned by Paramount Global now. This recording was inducted into the National Recording Registry in 2009. So I'm going to show you the records here. As you see, and it's pretty old, and the sleeve, this record is, I believe, close to 75 years old. It's obviously starting to come apart. I've had to make a number of adjustments, but I like that this, whoever this June Pierce person is, actually took pretty decent care of these discs in the long amount of time that they've lived. So we're going to hear this record. So we're going to hear all four parts of this record, which these records, I think, were numbered for record changers, which is why the part four is on the opposite side of part one. But I don't have a record changer, so I'm going to take both of these two records out at once, and we're going to switch over to the next record when the pages inside tell us to. And now with Paul Wing and the Little Nipper in tow, let's read The Little Engine That Could. Okay, now, let's go over to part two of this thing. Is that... No, that's part three. Put that over. There you go.
Of the cars, because it certainly looked as though they would never get to Jan to give the boys and girls their toys and dolls. And they were all very discouraged. All except... idea. He said there is more than one way of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. Aviators, start up the motors of your airplanes. They will pick up the train and fly it across the mountain. One by one, the toy aviators started the motors of their toy aeroplanes. And then when they had got them all running, they made them go faster and faster. And slowly but surely, the little train began to move. And from the whole train, up went a cheer. But the Toyland Special didn't fly up into the air at all. The cheer that had gone up went down. And the moment the train began to go up the mountain, it began to slow down. And the upper it went, the downer it slowed, until at last it just stopped stock still. And they were all very discouraged. All except the clown. The clown saw that they had come to a switch where another track ran into the track the Toyland Special was on. And coming toward them, on the other track, was a shiny new engine. The clown said, "Aha! There are more than two ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. What we need is an engine to pull us over. Maybe this is the engine that could." The clown waved his flag, and the shiny new engine stopped. The clown bowed politely and said, "How do you do? As you can see, our Toyland Special has broken down. We're looking for an engine to switch over onto our track and pull us over the mountain to yon. Are you the engine that could?" Well, the shiny new engine didn't answer. So the clown said loudly, "I'm sure you're the engine that could."
Now let's go over to part three.
I could, if I would, but I pulled a big strong train over the mountain with more big strong cars than you have ever dreamed of. And a caboose, he added. I am a very important big strong engine indeed. I will not pull the likes of you. And waving a front wheel disdainfully at the Toyland Special, he puffed off angrily to the roundhouse. Everybody was terribly discouraged. Everybody except the clown.
Now let's go over to the fourth and final part of this record. This is, I believe, in total, this record doesn't really go on for that long, come to think of it. It's probably, it's a pretty short little EP, final thing in total.
The clown said, listen to me, there are more than five ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. Because I think I hear another engine coming right now. Perhaps this is the engine that could. It was a rusty old engine, wheezing and coughing as he came down the track and stopped. Please, sir, pleaded the clown, will you pull our little train over the mountain? But the rusty old engine shook his cowcatcher sadly and said, I would, if I could. But I can't. I feel terrible. I must rest my rheumatic wheels. I cannot pull even so little a train as yours. And then he chugged off to the roundhouse saying, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot, I cannot. Well, the dolls and toys were all frightfully discouraged. But not the little clown. Don't be sad, shouted the clown. There are more than six ways of getting over the mountain from hither to yon. And just at that very moment, they heard a whistle. And a little, oh, a very little bright blue engine chugged merrily up to them and stopped. Perhaps this was the engine that could. Explained their trouble. My, said the little bright blue engine, I'm not very big. I've never pulled a train over the mountain. But I will, if I can, and I'll try. The little bright blue engine backed into the Toyland Special and coupled onto it. And the clown said anxiously, it takes a strong engine to pull us over the mountain. Are you sure you're the kind of engine that could? As the little bright blue engine started to pull, he said, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. When the little bright blue engine pulled the Toyland Special up the mountain, closer and closer to the top, soon they were almost at the very top. Just a few more chugs and they'd be over the mountain. The clown was worried. He said, do you think you can make it? And the little bright blue engine said, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could, I thought I could. And he said it all the way down the mountain until they reached the town of Yon. And so the Toyland Special got over the mountain from hither to yon. And all the boys and girls in the town of Yon got their toys and dolls after all. And that is the story of the little engine that could. Thank you, Nipper.
All right, on the back of this, we have an ad for more Little Nipper storybook albums you're sure to enjoy. And these include Mother Goose Land, sung by Jack Arthur. Don't know who he is. I'm going to have to look him up sometime. And the other one is How the Circus Learned to Smile, told by Spike Jones. Which is Should be pretty interesting to hear. And, bottom. Your RCA Victor dealer has them! Non-breakable records. Yep, they kind of had to make a point in the early days of 45's LPs of stating that those were non-breakable because they came on a vinyl, which did not break apart as easily as the 78's, which came on shellac. Yeah, I think this is a pretty nice way to kill 15 minutes or so of time thinking on the turntable. I like Paul Wing's pretty distinctly joyful and emotional sort of narration. And the nice little colorful drawings that we're accompanied with, they remind me almost of, but not quite, of the artwork that was seen on some public domain cartoons from some cartoons of the 40s and the 30s that are some of which are in the public domain. All in all, a nice, enjoyable listen. The records were kept well, considering that they were records aimed at the wee ones that were released in 1949, and are, I think, 73 years old now. So they held up real well in terms of the effectiveness. And, by the way, it says at the bottom here, produced by special arrangements with the copyright owners, the Platt & Monk Company Incorporated. I wonder what became of the Platt & Monk Company Incorporated. Well, that's a mystery I'm going to ponder some other time. I'll see you in the next video. Have a good day or night.